Hello and welcome, my dear students. Today we are going to start the topic, that is prepositions. Now, what are prepositions? A preposition is a word placed before a noun or pronoun to show its relation with some other word in the sentence. So, what is a preposition? A word placed before a noun or pronoun. Now the word which is placed before, pre means before. So the word which is placed before a noun or pronoun to show its relation with some other words in the sentence. And it shows the relation with some other words in the sentence. Such word is called as preposition. Now let us see some examples of prepositions. Now you can see the bird is on the tree. Next example, the bird is under the tree. The bird is in the cage and the bird is between the flowers, right? So the words like on, under, in, between, these are all prepositions because they show the relation between the bird and other words in the sentence. So in the first example, it shows the relation between the bird and the tree. Second example, it shows the relation between the bird and the tree again. Third example shows the relation between the bird and the cage. And last example shows the relation between the bird and the flowers. And you must have noticed that all these words like trees, cage, flowers, these are nouns and the preposition is placed before it. Okay, so that word which is placed before a noun or pronoun and which shows the relation. The following are the different kinds of prepositions. A. Simple preposition, compound preposition, double preposition, participle preposition, phrase preposition. So now let us see all these kinds one by one. So the first is simple preposition. Now simple preposition contains only two syllables. Simple prepositions are words like for, by, at, out, in, of, through, till, up, to, with, etc. So these all are simple prepositions. Now let us see examples how to use these simple prepositions. The whale dived into the water, creating a massive splash. So which is the preposition? Into. Next, I am from New Jersey. From. Martha is here till her brother gets into college. Till. The moon does not shine by its own. By. My niece is suffering from flu. From. I am working hard at geography. At. So these are all simple prepositions. Compound prepositions are those prepositions that are made by prefixing the preposition to a noun, an adjective or an adverb. The prepositions which are made by adding a prefix. Prefixing means adding a prefix. What is a prefix? Pre means before. So to add the letter or letters before a word, is called as prefix. So prefix plus noun, adjective or adverb. So that is called as compound preposition. Let us see the examples. Amongst. So M-O-N-G-S-T, amongst, we have added here A. Midst, amidst. Bow, above. Round, around. Long, along. Cross, across. So in this way, when you add a prefix to a noun, an adjective or an adverb, it becomes a compound preposition. Let us have a look at examples. A prefix plus noun, adjective or adverb. The cat is jumping around the seat. Now round. Round is an adjective and we have added a before it. So it has become preposition, around. Amidst the confusion, Nancy stayed calm and saved the drowning kid. Midst is a noun. We have added a before it and amidst preposition is formed. Amongst all children, Cindy is the brightest in music. Amongst is the compound preposition. The car pulled along the driveway. Along, long is an adjective and we have added a prefix A before it and it has become along, compound preposition. There is a metro station beneath this ground. Neath, and we have added B before it and it has become a compound preposition. Okay, let's move ahead. Let us see some more examples of compound preposition. Our dog stayed outside our home in his kennel. So which is the compound preposition? Outside. Now, out and side, these are two different words joined together. The children ran around the beach. The preposition is around. There is a friendly mouse inside my cupboard. In plus side, inside. Her beauty is beyond imagination. Beyond. Once upon a time, there was a brave princess. Upon. Up on. Two words joined together. So these are called compound prepositions. Let's move ahead. Next is double preposition. Now what is double preposition? When two prepositions are used together, they are called double prepositions. Sometimes a compound preposition is formed by joining two words, but unlike that, double prepositions are always two separate words. Now we have seen earlier, inside, upside. So these were also formed by adding two words, but these were not double prepositions, they were compound prepositions. So double prepositions are used together. When two prepositions are used together, they are called double preposition. Double prepositions, they are always two separate words. Okay, outside of. Now see here, outside is one word separate, off is another word. So these are used separately, not together. So they are called double prepositions. Out of. Out is one word and off is other word. From out. From behind. From beneath, etc. So these are two separate words. But in a compound preposition, we have seen that two words joined together and is used as one word. So that is compound. When it two prepositions or two words are used together as a single word, then it is compound prepositions. and double prepositions are always used separately. They are always two separate words. So that is a point you have to keep in mind. Okay. Now next, let us see examples of double prepositions. Double prepositions, how are they formed? By adding simple two prepositions. Already you have seen which are the simple prepositions. So when these two simple prepositions are used together, it is called as double preposition. For example, my son emerged from behind. Now from and behind. So this is double prepositions. Two prepositions are used separately. My son emerged from behind the curtains to scare me. According to the meteorology department, it is going to rain tonight. So according to, this is double preposition. Next is it up to nature to replenish our renewable resources? Up to, it is double preposition. Zeal is something that comes from within a person, from within. So when these two words are used separately, they are called as double prepositions.